Welcome to this video about myocardial infarction. Our heart is the muscle that pumps blood throughout our body, bringing life-giving oxygen and much-needed nutrients. It also has its own blood supply via the coronary arteries. The term myocardial means muscle of the heart. An infarction is an interruption of the blood supply to a tissue, usually caused by a blood clot or thrombus. Therefore, a myocardial infarction is the interruption of the blood supply to the heart. This typically occurs due to blockage of coronary arteries. Loss of blood to an area of the heart equals loss of oxygen. When our tissues in the body are deprived of oxygen for a period of time, they can become damaged and even die. Myocardial infarction is commonly referred to as a heart attack. A heart attack occurs in three stages: ischemia, injury, and infarction. Ischemia is a restriction of blood flow, and thus a shortage of oxygen, to tissues in the body. Again, this occurs typically due to an occlusion or blood clot. Prolonged lack of oxygen to the heart muscle causes injury to the cells of the myocardium. If the circulation is not restored, cell death or infarction occurs, meaning a portion of the heart muscle dies or sustains permanent damage. Three types of heart attacks are ST segment elevation myocardial infarction, or STEMI, non-ST segment elevation myocardial infarction, or non-STEMI, and coronary spasm, also known as unstable angina. STEMI is named for the ST elevation seen on an electrocardiogram. The PQRST waves show the electrical conduction through the heart muscle, and when ST is elevated, this is demonstrating a partial or complete blockage of a major coronary artery and is life-threatening. Depending on the number and type of blockages, the patient may need to have an emergent cardiac catheterization to remove the blockage or open heart surgery. Non-STEMI is a heart attack where a minor coronary artery is completely or partially blocked and will also need to be treated quickly, but no elevation of the ST segment will be seen on the electrocardiogram. If you think about the electrical conduction of the heart muscle for a second, completely blocking an artery will alter the electrical conduction by stopping or detouring the blood flow. The heart muscle will not be able to contract as it should, causing the electrical conduction to change as seen on an ECG. Coronary artery spasm, or angina, is a sudden tightening of the arteries, again restricting the blood flow to the heart muscle. These are usually brief and temporary, but can lead to a heart attack. The clinical manifestations of heart attack include crushing chest pain, arms feeling heavy, shortness of breath, coughing, nausea, vomiting, dizziness, a gray color of the face, and feeling clammy and sweaty. Not all patients have the same symptoms or the same severity of symptoms, especially when comparing men and women. Some of the other symptoms reported are jaw pain, back pain, flu-like symptoms, fatigue, or no symptoms. Most myocardial infarctions affect the wall of the left ventricle of the heart, which is the chamber that pumps blood to the body. So if it sustains damage, this can have systemic effects. When the left anterior descending coronary artery is blocked, then the infarct may affect the anterior wall of the left ventricle, anterior aspect of ventricular septum, and/or the apex of the heart. When the right coronary artery is blocked, then the infarct may involve the posterior wall of the left ventricle, the posterior aspect of the ventricular septum, and may extend to the posterior wall of the right ventricle. When the left circumflex coronary artery is blocked, then the infarct may involve the lateral wall of the left ventricle. When diagnosing a heart attack, there are many different tests a healthcare provider may perform. They may perform an ECG to check the electrical conduction of the heart, do a chest X-ray, blood work to look for elevated cardiac markers, a CT scan, or an MRI. Cardiac catheterization is an invasive test that can tell practitioners if there is a blockage, which can sometimes be removed or repaired at the same time. One of the blood tests looks for troponin levels, which is an enzyme released by the heart muscle when it sustains damage. An increase in troponin occurs within 2 to 3 hours of heart muscle injury and can be used to diagnose or exclude the occurrence of a heart attack. Some other blood tests include C-reactive protein, or CRP, fibrinogen, homocysteine, lipoproteins, triglycerides, brain natriuretic peptide, or BNP, and prothrombin. Reasons for these tests include confirming that a heart attack has occurred and determining the extent of damage, assessing future risk for coronary artery disease, and providing information on the time it takes for the blood to clot. Myocardial infarction is a very scary and potentially life-threatening event. If a patient is experiencing any of the signs and symptoms of heart attack, whether mild or severe, they should seek medical attention immediately. There are many lifestyle changes that can aid in preventing a heart attack. Eating a healthy diet, maintaining a healthy weight, exercise, and lowering stress are just a few. Thanks for watching and happy studying!